Today we're going to talk about the end of month function. Here we have the date. Now the end of month function works particularly well for calculating maturity dates or due dates. Now this can be entered for either for previous months or for coming up months. So here we have a date put in here. And so let's go and let's try this out. Let's say this month was the last month of payments on, let's say, for a car loan for 36 months. So what we're going to do is we're going to go EOM, which is the end of month function. And then you put in the date that you want to work from. And so then we put comma, and then we put the number of months. So we've been paying on this car loan for, let's say, 35 months. So let's put on negative 35. And that will tell you when you started paying off this car. So we press enter. And there you have, you started paying off this car on December 31st, 2002. Now, let's go the other way. Let's go equals, let's say we're buying a car today, and so we go end of month. And then we select the date. And then let's say we want to know when our last payment is going to be for 36 months. So our last payment is going to be November 30th, 2018. If we wanted to see what the end of the next quarter would be, or the end of, 3 months from now. So let's go equals. There we go. Select our date one more time, and we'll put in 3. Okay, this is more the normal reaction. It gives you the serial number rather than the date. So what we're going to do is we are going to click on the date format, the previous one. We're going to take our format painter off our toolbar here, and then we're going to click on our date. And then we're going to double click to make it wide enough. And there we see 3 months from today, or 3 months from the end of today, is the 29th day of February 2016. So there you have the end of month calculator.